screen. And yeah, as you saw, that's the end of the glitch that started for 13. Okay, so now past the part I hate, my screen's gonna come down. Maybe. But this is the other part I don't hate it, but I don't like it. It's the first time I played through this, it just kicked my ass. It really did. So, listen, I didn't show it, but what was happening there is the replicas were fighting the, I guess you could say, well, those aren't mercenaries, they're in a cleanup crew. Yeah, they're a cleanup crew. It's kind of loud. Ah, it's better. I feel like I have to yell. Okay, so basically this part is, it's not really hard, but for some reason I had a hard time with it the first time around. Probably because I screwed up so much. First time I played through this part, I actually, what I did was, I'll tell you in a minute. I'll show you, I'm not going to show you because I didn't do it in this one because I was able to, but anyways, my rambling. The point is, what I did is, when I got to the second valve, what I did was, I turned the difficulty down to easy. Because it was just such a pain. But this time I did it without turning the difficulty down, and I don't think I even died, so... I didn't even get close, I didn't die though, so that's good. But it's just a bit of a pain, maybe your first time around. You might have better luck than I did, but... Basically, anytime you touch something in this... Like one of those valves, anytime you touch a valve, after you go to the lift, prepare to shoot something. Because they don't like you touching things, or going near them, or contemplating them, or conceiving the thought of just going by it. Don't do it. Is that so hard? I don't know what's going on there. It's a different clip, but apparently I clicked I went up twice. I don't know why. Okay, so watch this. Wait, ready? Ready? I'm not even touching. That's scary. Really bad. Take your advice, buddy. Let's come around there. Whap. Knock him out. So, in this part, be prepared to shoot a lot of people. Because as soon as you even think about touching something, you're going to get shot at. Which really sucks a lot. Truly does. Truly. Yeah, just turn the valve, turn it, spin that thing, spin it. Okay. After you take care of those guys, nothing else happens, so don't worry about that. But it's before you touch the valves that all the crap goes down, mostly. So, the second valve, you can do these in any order you want. Doesn't matter. Okay. Ah, sorry. Internet popped up for some reason. I'm sorry. I've been Disney, you son of a stupid thing. Yeah, that's my internet for you. Okay, now, after you touch the second valve, or this valve, I'm not sure how it works, I usually do this one second. A big robot is gonna come right through that door, and as soon as you see the bullets fly, throw a equip and then throw a, I guess it's not really a grenade, it's just a shock grenade. But you know, if you get hit by it, don't worry, it doesn't really do all that much damage, I don't think, like you can see in a second. And no matter how gutsy you think you are, don't take this thing head on without, don't kind of like stop. It's a really dumb idea. You're not gonna win. And if you do, okay, good for you, you're crazy, but for the average person, don't do that. You're probably gonna die, especially if you're playing this thing at work. Now we got down to a bit less than half health. I think maybe quarter health. Always remember to take cover, grab ammo if needed, toss that tater, charge. Now, as soon as he turns blue, he's dead, but I didn't know that. It is. Darn it. Screwed up my countdown. Okay, so after you do those two, no one will get you. The thing is, you can do them in any order you want, so I'm not sure what happens. Because if you do this one first and no one comes after you, that means you have to deal with the other two. Otherwise, you can do all those two first and do this last one. You don't have to do anything, really. But, you know, I don't know. I never really experimented with it because that's just the order I do it in, closest to farthest. I'm just lazy. I'm sorry. I blame my genetics. You press that wheel button, and then that big door opens, and then that's the end. You've survived Arkham Asylum, or whatever the heck it's called.
Pop, I've got something on the data net. I think it's Beckett. Oh, thank God you're alive.
Told you not to worry, Stokes. He's tough like me.
Beckett, no, tougher. I just took out an entire building of crazy people, plus an entire cavern of crazy people, plus a load of other crazy people. They're just ludicrous. Who? Yeah, you know what I mean. They're crazy. That's my point. Ah, my back. Okay, so we're coming to the end here. Yay. So this is part 14. Yep, 14. Yay, number 14. Woot! Okay, so this is part 14, and pretty soon here. Closing note. I don't really have one. Yep. As usual,
what the hell was that place,
anyway? Have a good day slash night.
You got me, Todd.
You comment, rate, subscribe.
Part of Project Harbinger.
My voice is very annoying. Stereotypical, actually.
Oh, it hasn't worked out as well. Sergeant,
okay. So, have a good one, guys. I'll see you around.
Genevieve Aristi thinks she can contain all of us,
but
her plan is going to backfire. All is too powerful to be contained. She probably always was.
So what are we supposed to do?
Destroy her. Okay. I'll see you guys later, and thank you for watching. Have a good one. Right now, we need